In this video, I'll show you how to remove the Powered by Shopify in your site footer. Hi, I'm Jake Lett. I share digital marketing tips to help you grow your business. Okay, let's get started. Before I make the change, I want to look at the HTML code to see how this is actually structured. In order to do that, I'm going to right-click on the window and hit Inspect. And this will open up the Chrome Developer Tools panel. And if you're not familiar with HTML code, don't be concerned. I'm going to walk you through the steps of how to use this tool. In this case, I'm just going to use it to inspect the element and see how it's built with code. So I'm going to click on this little icon here that says Select the Element icon. Once you click on that, you can hover over any element on the page and click on it, and that'll inspect that particular part of the page. So I'm going to do Powered by Shopify, click on that, and you'll see where it says copyright content, and then there's an anchor link and it says Powered by Shopify. So that's what I'm trying to remove. Ideally, I like to remove this whole anchor link. So one thing I noticed is the help article or help video that's on the Shopify Help Center, it walks you through the steps of removing the actual text. And I'll show you what happens when you do that. So once you're logged into your store, on the left-hand side, click on Online Store, and then click on these three little dots here, and do Edit Default Theme Content. And then in here, search for Powered By. And here it is right here. And the help video, what they tell you to do is, you can't remove, actually delete this, because if I hit delete, the text is still there. So in order to hide this text, you have to actually do a space and hit save. And if I refresh my site page, I should see this removed. So it is removed, but if you inspect the code, you'll see the anchor link is still there. So yes, it's not visible to you or to any of your visitors, but you're still passing a link back to Shopify. One thing, I don't think that's a good thing that Shopify is allowing that to happen, because it's probably getting them a lot of links. So if you want to remove this anchor link, the actual code, here's what I recommend doing. Go back into your store admin panel and click on your online store link here. And we're going to edit the code. And I'm going to walk you through the steps. So if you've never edited code before, don't be concerned. It's not as bad as it seems. So we're going to do edit code. And inside the search files, I want you to search for footer.liquid. And I already have it open here, but I'm just going to click on this here. And once you have the footer.liquid open, scroll down, and you're looking for a piece of text that says Powered by Link. If you want to, you could do a search. So you could do Control F or Command F on a Mac and do Powered by, and there it is. So this is the actual, this liquid function, which is code, is actually going to output the anchor link. So if I remove this and do save and go back to my store and refresh, I should see that anchor link removed now. And that you can see it's not there in the code anymore. So this is the way that I recommend moving the Powered by Shopify, is by actually going into the code, the footer.liquid file, and removing that liquid token, Powered by Link. After saving the file, if you notice something is wrong with your site and you want to revert back to what the code was before, you just click on this drop-down menu, and you would pick 36 minutes ago. And you would hit save. To refresh the page again, and do inspect. And you'll see the anchor link is there, but you notice the text is missing because of that language file that we updated. So if I go back, and do edit default theme content, search for powered, and remove that space, hit save, and then if I go back to my page and refresh, you'll see it's there, back as it was. If you have any questions about this process, you can leave them in the comments of this video. And if it's been helpful to you, please like the video. I really appreciate that. If you'd like to watch more videos about your Shopify store setup, click this playlist right here. Also, be sure to check out my free digital marketing downloads and templates. You can find a link to them in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.